In this example, we are given that in the given arrangement of a uniformly charged U-shaped wire with a linear charge density lambda, we are required to find the electric field strength at point C, which is the center of the semicircular arc at the bottom of this U-shaped wire. Now, in this situation, for solution, we can directly write electric field at C due to segment 1 is, here we can divide this wire into 3 segments, like first is this segment, second is this segment, and the third is the semicircular segment. So this first segment is the semi-infinite wire, and from this wire at a distance A, we are required to find the electric field due to this 2. We are again required to find electric field at a distance A, and due to the segment 3, we are required to find the electric field at the center of curvature of the semicircle, and we'll add all these results. So in this situation, we can say electric field at C due to segment 1 is E1 vector, and due to this first segment, we can say electric field will exist in this direction, which is at an angle 45 degree from this vertical line, and the value of this electric field will be root 2 k lambda by A. And here we have studied that its x and y electric field can be directly written as k lambda by A. So electric field due to 1 can be written as k lambda by A I cap minus k lambda by A j cap. Similarly, we can find out the electric field at C due to segment 2 is this E2 vector, and due to the second semi-infinite wire, electric field will be in this direction at an angle 45 degree from the vertical line. And here again, the electric field will be in x and y direction as k lambda by A. So this can be written as minus k lambda by A I cap minus k lambda by A j cap. And if we find out electric field at C due to wire segment 3, then it is given as E3, and directly E3 can be given in positive y direction, and this E3 can be directly given by the expression of a circular arc, which is given as 2k q sin phi by 2 by phi r square. So here phi will be pi. So this pi by 2 divided by pi a square, where a is the radius, and total charge on the semicircular segment can be written as lambda multiplied by pi a. If we substitute the value here, we can see E3 can be given as, this obviously in j cap direction. So this q, when we substitute as lambda multiplied by pi a, this can be written as 2k lambda by a j cap. So net electric field at the point C can be written as E1 vector plus E2 vector plus E3 vector. If we substitute the values, it is k lambda by a I cap minus k lambda by a j cap plus minus of k lambda by a I cap minus k lambda by a j cap plus 2k lambda by a j cap. You just have a look carefully here. This section will cancel out. This will also cancel out with this. So total result will be 0. That will be the answer of this problem.